So the spatula I made in the last video turned out great, but I couldn't stop at just one utensil. So I needed a matching spoon, and I jumped back into Blender to do some 3D modeling and create the basic shape. I imported the file as an STL into Vectric VCarve and created all my toolpaths in the app. I use Vectric because it is the best way to do VCarving, even though it doesn't do a good job at other 3D toolpaths. I picked up a piece of Madron wood and did the rough shaping on the bandsaw. This allowed me to orient the grain in the direction that I wanted. I had already surfaced this piece of lumber, so all I had to do was joint one edge flat. From there, I could take it to the table saw and rip the other side parallel to my desired width. I've been using some wood dowels to orient my workpiece on my CNC table. The XY origin doesn't have to be very accurate in this particular case, and what's important is the Z axis being measured from my table. The first operation is to drill some quarter inch holes. I'll put some wood dowels into these and use it to indicate in the backside of the workpiece. My CNC spoil board already has some mirrored holes drilled into it from this spatula project that I did before. I carved the piece with two bits. I used a quarter inch upcut bit for the roughing operation, and I used a 1/8 of an inch ball nose bit for the finishing operation. I then put some blue tape over the portion that's going to be carved for the inlay, and I did a V-carve with a 15-degree V-bit. Once the top side of the spoon was all done, I could remove it from the hold downs. I want to be able to place it again in this exact same location, so I insert some wood dowels into the holes on the top, and I flip it over. I put the dowels down into the holes that were already drilled into my spoil board and clamp it back down. Then I run the exact same drill pattern that I did at the start. This way I can flip it over again and it will be perfectly aligned to the top. This will make sense in just a little bit. Once the top side was done, I could move on to the wood inlay plug. For this, I picked some walnut because walnut would provide a nice contrast to the reddish tones of the Madron wood. As before, the XY orientation on the plug wasn't too important, but the Z needed to be fairly accurate. So I touched off the Z with my Heimer indicator to get an accurate origin for the Z axis. The trick for a curved inlay is to create the inverse of the curved surface that you're projecting in on. So this is going to be sort of a concave section that I machine out with a same 1/8 inch ball nose bit. Once that curved surface is done, I can do the typical plug creation using a V-bit. And again, I'm using the same 15-degree V-bit as before. The female inlay and the male plug require a little bit of cleanup. I just use a sharp X-Acto knife to get rid of the fuzzies. Gluing in the plug is fairly straightforward using some waterproof wood glue. I clamp it down tight and let it sit overnight. Once it's dry, I cut off with the bandsaw. I can then use the holes in the bottom side of the workpiece to align it back on the table and mount it down with the same clamps again. I run the same spoon carving operations, but limit the area to just around the rows. This is just like the original carving. I do a roughing pass with a 1/4 inch bit, and then a final pass with the 1/8 inch ball nose bit. Once that's done, I can remove it, use the dowels to align it onto the table again, and do the bottom side. Once it was all done, I cut the tabs out using a multi-tool and started sanding. Sanding wood is way easier than sanding epoxy, and I just had to use some 150 grit and 220 grit to do it. Before I put on the finish, I raised the grain. This means I wipe it with a damp rag and let it dry. I then sand it again with 220 to remove any fuzziness. After it all looks good, I can put on a coat of finish. I use walrus oil, which is a food safe oil, typically used for cutting boards. I just put on one coat, super easy to apply, wipe it on, let soak in a bit, and wipe it off. Now I want you guys to be able to make one of these. I have the files available on my website, so go check it out. The link is in the description. I include the model, the Vectric VCarve file with all my setups and how I do it. All you have to do is change the feeds and speeds for your particular machine's capabilities. I also include a STL file in case you don't use Vectric VCarve. Doing the inlay is optional. You don't have to do that. And it is a little bit trickier to get the inlay to look just perfect. If you do end up making one, send me a photo. I'd love to see it. Thanks, everyone.